Hey everyone, this is Marco, the Bob Ross of ESO, and I'm back with a special series for new and returning players. Over the course of a few videos, we'll break down the basics and help you get the most out of The Elder Scrolls Online, which is, in my opinion, still the best MMO you can play at the moment. Now if you like this vibe and you don't want to miss out on the future content, I'd really like it if you could subscribe. It costs you absolutely nothing, and it helps this channel out in a big way. Okay, you just started your first character in ESO, and you're completely and utterly overwhelmed. That's understandable. The game is huge, and we've all been there. Sometimes with so many options and things to do, you just get lost in the sheer size of it all. So I'm going to give you a few things that I, as a veteran player, think you should prioritize as soon as you log on. Whether you're going to play for an hour or do a marathon stretch, there are some good habits to get into right away. I'm not going to just give you theories or concepts. Here's my character, Hooks. I built him just to demonstrate things for this channel. He's level 25, so just a newbie character. If you keep watching, you're going to see him earn hundreds of thousands of gold in just a few minutes of playtime. Now fresh characters need several things. Experience so you can level up, gold so you can buy cool things, and skill points so you can learn new abilities. If you just try to power level, well, you're going to miss out on a lot of the best aspects of the game, so you'll be lacking in several areas. I'm going to give you a few tips on how to make gold when your character is under level 50. Now the guild-centric economy in ESO can be confusing. It was to me. So I'll be doing an entire video about how and why to join a trading guild very soon. But I will say this. Even if you're a painfully shy solo player, to make gold in this game, you have to sell to other players, and the trading guilds are the way to do that. Relax though. You don't have to be a social butterfly to put things up for sale. So you're a newbie player with a character who is under level 50. You can't sell any of your armor or weapon pieces because no one wants that low-level gear. So what can you sell to make big bank? Mats, motifs, furnishing plans, and fragments, that's what. Mats, or materials, is what high-level characters always need to make food, potions, furnishings, and everything else that can be player-made in the game. Now often players would rather just buy the mats so that they don't have to waste their own time farming them. And that's where you come in. The pro tip. Your backpack or your inventory. You want to upgrade that as often and as quickly as you can afford to. You'll go to a pack merchant, my favorite is a guy named Rolding in the middle of Elden Hollow, and buy more space. And also becoming an ESO Plus subscriber gives you the bottomless craft bag, which is a must for people like me, but that's up for you to decide. Okay, what's the best way for you to farm mats? First, do your crafting writs as soon as you log on. You'll get thousands of gold and mats that you can sell. You'll see Hooks, even at this low level, makes about 3,500 gold every single day just by doing writs. That doesn't include the materials, maps, and other things that he gets. Writs will eventually make you rich, so do them every day. And don't forget about jewelry making, which is a skill that you can pick up in Somerset from the quest giver named Falarion. There are loads of things that a new player can farm that will sell to other players instantly. A perfect row, for instance, from fishing. Stendar Stamp from deconstructing steadfast metal gear in High Isle is a brand new item that everybody wants. Now even heartwood, which comes from just chopping wood in any zone, can make you gold. I even know someone that farms mud crabs. Next tip. If you're a new player and you have access to any of the four companions, keep them out while you play. Companion gear has no level, and you can sell purple gear for a tidy sum. Okay, fragments. I've done several videos on these, which I'll link in the descriptions below. Public dungeons, like Carnwaston in Somerset, or Zenithar's Abbey in Blackwood, have rare drops which can be combined for cool pets or furnishings. Veteran players will pay tons of gold if you'll just spend the time farming them so they don't have to. But the fastest way for the under level 50 crowd to make quick cash is selling rare motifs and furnishing plans. You'll want to go to the newest or nearly newest zones to try for these. And the great thing is, as a low level player, you'll have lots of other players who will unwittingly help you stay alive. Now my character Hooks has picked up the daily monster quest in Fargrave. I highly recommend that you do this every day. It only takes about 5 minutes and, well, I want you to watch and see what goodies my level 25 character gets for his trouble. Another pro tip, when in Fargrave, you always want to go to the Bearer's Rest Inn and head upstairs. Here you can easily steal everything in sight and not get caught. It will help level your ledger domain, and occasionally a very rare furnishing plan can drop from up there. Now remember, Ember is the only companion who likes thievery, so put the other companions to bed before you go up to Bearer's Rest. As you can see by the turn-in of my Fargrave daily, I received a motif worth more than 200,000 gold and a furnishing plan that sells for over 100,000 gold. Now remember, this quest took my level 25 character about 5 minutes to complete. That's pretty amazing, right? Now of course, your mileage may vary. RNG does strange things to every player. But since I was making this video, I decided to go back the very next day with the same character and do it all again. The second time, I received a motif worth over 350,000 gold. So, I'm sold. Do your writs, then do some of these dailies, and you'll be raking in the gold as a newbie player. And speaking of people who are fairly new to ESO, I wanted to give a shout out to my new friend Ruben, who's been coming to my streams and asking great questions. I love talking about the game with both new and veteran players while I live stream. Please come by and chat with me on YouTube or on Twitch, and follow me to know when I'm on. I'd love to hear your thoughts on earning gold and experience on a new character. If you just started playing ESO, don't worry. We're going to help you every step of the way, make your journey more fun and less confusing. As always, I'm Marco. Have fun playing ESO. Be kind to other players, and keep exploring.